Rouhani's election comes at a crucial time in negotiations over Iran's nuclear program, which has come almost to the brink of conflict. Vali Nasser is a former member of President Obama's foreign policy team at the State Department, and he is now Dean of the School of International Studies at Johns Hopkins University. And I spoke to him moments ago. Vali Nasser, welcome back to the program.
Good to be here.
Is this a real opportunity for the United States right now?
Yes, it is. First of all, just having a reformist, a person different than Mahmoud Ahmadinejad as the president of Iran, provides much more breathing room, much more space for the administration and the international community to try something new with Iran. And then, after all, Rouhani was the architect of probably the most forward-leaning position Iran ever had on the nuclear deal back in 2003.
In other words, the suspension of their program for a significant period of time.
Yes, and he's held on to that view because literally every diplomat that Ahmadinejad fired for favoring engagement with the U.S. was later on hired by Rouhani in his think tank.
But
so he's been working on this.
Roundly criticized for that. Do you think that suspension is even a glimmer of a hope under him now?
Well, he's once bitten, twice shy. In other words, he's not going to stick his neck out for it to be chopped off. That's the challenge for the United States and the P5 plus one. They have to give him something tangible, so he's not seen as naive and repeating the same mistake as 2003. So we shouldn't read reformism as immediate capitulation or an open door for a deal. We have work to do, but the opportunity is there.
Now, you have written that actually the ball is in the U.S. court right now. What do you mean?
Well, because the United States has to at least suggest that it's willing to deal with Rouhani different than they dealt with Ahmadinejad. In the past, the impression in Iran was that Ahmadinejad got better deals than Rouhani did. And Rouhani can't come to the table seriously unless the indication is that he can deliver more than Ahmadinejad. We have to help strengthen his hand in Iran. That way he can actually sell a deal back home.
Now, you've been inside the administration. You've worked on Afghanistan and Pakistan, but obviously Iran as well. Is there a willingness to get beyond this really terrible 34-year wall of mistrust that has gone up between the two countries?
I don't think so. I think the administration's handled Iran tactically, in other words, managing it one step at a time with an eye on American domestic public opinion. There hasn't been an audacious view of bringing Iran in from the cold, as difficult as that might be. And I think the election of Rouhani is a challenge for the Obama administration because they hadn't planned for it. They were waiting for Jalili or some hardliner. They have to go back to the drawing board and come up with a new plan, but I hope they do, because the president does have some more room with Congress and with the American public than he would have had Jalili or a hardliner been elected.
But let's just call a spade a spade. I've spoken to Iranian officials, former negotiators, actually people who worked for Dr. Rouhani earlier, and they said that so far the American incentives to Iran in this nuclear negotiations amounts to demanding diamonds for peanuts. In other words, the incentives that the U.S. has given so far don't amount to much.
They don't amount to much at all. The United States has only offered aircraft parts and most recently modest permission to trade in gold and silver. What Iran is really after is offer of taking serious sanctions off the table, which has not been there, and possibly recognizing Iran's right to enrichment. Rouhani has to be able to show Iran's supreme leader and revolutionary guards that the reformists can actually get the United States to offer these things. That's how you build momentum for reform in Iran.
And of course, Iran has to show the United States, the West, and Israel that there's going to be total transparency and that they're not going for a weapon. Can he deliver on that?
This is a give and take. In other words, each side has to risk a little and be willing to offer something, and then you go from there. So he's talked about transparency. He's talked about constructive engagement. Those are all positive things. We have to test those things. But he has to also know that if he takes a serious step in the direction of transparency, that he will not end up where he ended up in 2000.
But do you think the regime as a whole wants this? Supreme leader, the Revolutionary Guards, do they want a ratcheting down of the crisis?
I think they want the sanctions to go away. Iran is really hurting. They may not want to give up the nuclear program, but they know that they can't survive under the sanctions, that the country is hurting. So lifting sanctions is an objective, and they have to realize they have to give something for that, and that has to come out of a constructive negotiation process.
Let's move quickly to Syria, because Dr. Rouhani has actually talked about it just the day before his election. In an interview in Iran, he said, In my opinion, in order to reach a just solution in Syria that's accepted by all parties, Iran can play the role of mediator between the Syrian government and the opposition that's working hard to achieve democracy and good governance. Can Iran actually play a role? Because right now we know the role it's playing is bolstering Assad and actually helping turn the tide in Assad's favor along with Hezbollah in Syria.
Well, Iran wants this conflict to go away. They don't want to lose, but they want the conflict to stop, and that's the beginning. And secondly, you're not going to get to any kind of a peace deal on Syria unless Iran is on board, because Iran is the most important of Assad's backers. It is a possibility to use the new face in Iran to see whether we can engage them, and is a potential to see whether Rouhani would be willing to play a constructive role in the Geneva conference. It's a very, very slim chance, but we have to use this opening in Iran to try new things with them. If we treat Iran the way we did before, as if there has been no change at the top, then there will be no change in Iran.
Vali Nasser, thank you very much indeed.
Good to be with you.